गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 13, जेंगो फॉर्म्स फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट वेब फ्रेमवर्क्स. सो दीज आर द कंटेंट्स फ्रॉम द चैप्टर नंबर 13, दैट इज फॉर्म क्लासेस, वैलिडेशंस, ऑथेंटिकेशंस, एडवांस फॉर्म प्रोसेसिंग टेक्निक्स. फर्स्ट वी विल स्टार्ट द जेंगो फॉर्म्स. So here Django provides a form class which is used to create HTML forms. It describes a form and how it works and appears. Django provides a form class for creating HTML forms. So when one creates a form class, the most important part is defining the fields of that form. So here each field has custom validation logic along with a few other hooks. So whenever we are going to creating a form class, we have to define that fields for that particular form. So it is similar to the model form class that creates a form by using a model, but it does not require the model. So here each field of the form class map to the HTML form input elements, and each one is a class itself. It manages form data and performs validation while submitting the form. So here each field of that form class map to the HTML form input tag, input elements. So here Django form class. So here it is the heart of the system of that components is Django's form class. In much the same way that the Django model describes the logical structure of an object or its behavior and the way its parts are represented to us, a form class describes a form and determines how it works and appears. So Django form class is the heart of that system or the component of that Django's form. So here, whenever we are going to describe any Django's model or it describes a logical structure of that object and its behavior, here in a similar way that the model class fields map to the database fields, here a form class fields map to a HTML form input elements. Like that means a model form maps a model class fields to HTML form input elements via a form. Then the form fields are themselves classes. Fields of that forms are themselves classes. They manage form data and perform validation when a form is submitted. A date field and a file field handle very different kinds of data and have two different things with it. Here form field is represented to a user in the browser. Whenever we are going to create any form and we are going to execute that, it represented to a user in the browser as a HTML widget. That is, it is a piece of a user interface machinery. Here forms are basically used for taking inputs from the user in some manner, like and using that information for logical operations on database. Whenever we are going to create any form, that means we are going to take input from the user and we are going to provide some output based on that inputs to the user. That means we are going to perform some logical operations on the database. So we are going to see one example here. For example, like registering a user by taking input as the here, whenever we are going to create a form, we are going to accept input from the user. That means consider a registration form. That means in that form we are going to or we are going to take input from the user, like name, email ID, password, etc. things from the user. Here we are going to see an example for creating some fields for the user. That means we are going to create one form like that is from Django imports form class. Here we are going to import from the Django forms. Then create class student form, forms.form and colon. Here you can see two fields are there, first name and last name. Here first name is equals to forms.character field. It is a character field. Here forms.char field. Inside the bracket label for that field is label is equals to in double quote. You have to write like for the first name, enter first name and the max length for the first name. And for the last name, similarly forms.character field and label for that field like label is equals to enter last name and the maximum length for the particular field. Here we have created a student form that contains two field of character field type. Here character field is a class and used to create a HTML text input component in the form. So here the label is used to set HTML label of the component, and the maximum length is set for the input value. So whenever when it render, it produces the following. It produces a HTML to the browser, like here label for is equals to ID first name, then you have to enter the first name, then here see the HTML code for this form, like label for ID underscore first name, then enter first name in that label, their input type is equals to text, name is equals to first name, and required max length we have said that ID is equals to ID underscore first name. This is for the first name, and similarly for the last name, label for is equals to ID underscore last name, then enter last name, and the input type is equals to text, name is equals to last name, and required max length that we are going to set, and the ID. So here Django form does not include form tags. That form tags is present in the HTML code, but in Django form it does not contain or it does not include form tags or a submit button. Okay, so here this some commonly used fields and their details are there for the Django forms. Here see the boolean field. For the boolean field, that class is class boolean field, and this is the keyword arguments. We are going to provide keyword arguments for the boolean field. Then the HTML input is checkbox input. Okay, for that checkbox input, empty value. Okay, that value is false here. And for the character field, class is character field with the keyword arguments, and that HTML input is text input. And the value is whatever we have given as a empty value. Then choice field, class is choice field with the keyword arguments, and input is select. We have to select the choice. Then data field, or sorry, date field, class is date field, and input type is, or the HTML input is date field or the date input. Then date time field, class is date time field with the keyword arguments, and the HTML input is, we are going to select the date and time input. Then decimal field, for that class decimal field with the keyword arguments, and that HTML input is number input. For the email field, class is email field with the keyword arguments, and we are going to give as an input email. Like file field and image field. For the image field, class is image field with the keyword arguments, and here clearable file input. That is HTML input here. So these are some commonly used fields in the Django forms. Now we are going to see one example for building a form in Django. Suppose we want to create a form to get student information. Here we are going to create one forms, like forms.py file is there. So here we have to write like from Django import from forms. Then we are going to create a class, class student form. Forms.form, then colon here, then first name and last name, two fields we have taken here, is equals to, here first name is equals to forms dot, it is a character field, and the label is for enter first name with the maximum length. Then for the last name, forms dot, it is a character field, then the label enter last name and the maximum length. This is the form file, that is forms.py. This is, we are going to build a form. Then here instantiating form in Django. So now we need to instantiate the form in views.py file. So we have to write views.py file. For that, like write from django.shortcuts import render. We have to render that. So import render, then from myapp.form. That means here that we have created one directory myapp. Inside that we have written that form.py file. So here from myapp.form import student form. Student form is the class from the forms.py file. Then here we are going to import a student form from the myapp.from. Then we have to define an index. Define index for the request. Then student is equals to student form. Return render request. We have to proceed with the request index.html form student. Whenever we are going to search for the index.html, it will respond in the form of that student form that contains two fields, enter first name and enter last name. Then you are passing the context of the form into index template. Here, how this index.html looks like here. Here, see the document type HTML. HTML language is equals to English. Then head here. See the title. We are going to save the title. Then close that head tag in the body. Here now see, you can see the form tag in the HTML. Here form method is equals to post. Then class is equals to post form. Then here you can see the button type like submit, class, save button. Here button default here, save. Okay. Then this form will end with the form tag, body tag and HTML tag. This is the index file for the form. This is the index template. Then here, provided that URL in the urls.py, like from django.country import admin and from django.urls import path, that is path function. Then from my app import views, that we have created views.py here. We have to import that also. In the URL patterns, write path admin/admin.site.urls, and we have created one index here, index.html. So we have to set that URL like path index views.index. This is the url.py file. Then now, after entering the localhost :8000/index in the browser, it will produce the output like this here. You can see enter first name with the text box and enter last name and the button. This button will we have not created this button in the form, but it is included because we have created that index.html file, and that index.html file we have taken that button here. You can see button type is equal to submit and class is save. See the name of or label of that button here. Okay, after running this code in the browser, we will see this form. Like we have taken two attributes for the particular form for the student information. That is, we have taken the first name and last name. Okay, so that's it for today's session. We will stop here. Thank you.